Welcome to the Mother-Daughter-ish podcast. It's your mama's favorite podcast.
And the podcast your daughter always wanted.
This is Miss Dawn.
And Angelique.
From the 713. Houston, y'all. Get connected and stay connected weekly as new shows debut on Sunday, Wednesday, and please check out our Saturday Out and About showcases.
Enjoy the show. Please subscribe, like, share, comment, and tell every woman on the planet that you know about our show.
Here's our show for today.
Copyright disclaimer under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976. Allowances made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright statute that might otherwise be infringing. It is illegal to make a false copyright claim, and such actions may lead to our party seeking compensation for losses. This video was created and published by the Mother-Daughter-ish Show in their personal capacity. The opinions expressed in this video are the creator's own and should not be taken as a definitive fact. The validity of any evidence provided should be independently consulted and researched and resource verified for authenticity. And the Mother-Daughter-ish Show takes no responsibility for the actions of those viewing this video.
Thank you so kindly.
Happy New Year 2022 from Mother-Daughter-ish. We have a new series for you, and that's January 1st through January 31st. Our series title is New Year, New View. I know you're used to hearing New Year, New You, but we're going to go with New Year, New View. We hope you enjoy our topics, as we will give you two topics per day to give you to ponder on and look at it through a different lens to get a different view. Thank you for listening to Mother-Daughter-ish, and here's our show for today. Happy January the 28th. The month has gone by so fast that if I don't look at a calendar, I can't even remember what day it is. But today is National Fun at Work Day. Remember when I used to work in corporate America and I used to bring y'all to work and y'all would drink up all the hot chocolate?
Don't get me started, but yes.
Y'all loved that. And Josh was so in love with the girl that used to sit in the desk across from me. I think she was from the Dominican Republic, and he just thought she was so gorgeous. She did have the most beautiful curly hair I think I've ever seen in my life. It was just so curly and coily, but he was so in love. He would just sit at my desk and he would be like this. He would just stare at her. And I'm like, that's a little bit creepy. You might not want to stare at people.
How old was he?
Oh my goodness. Probably. Let me see. When we moved over here, you were probably pre-K, right? First grade. Maybe about five or six or seven, something like that. So young, just was in love with that girl. I thought it was so funny. But today is National Fun at Work Day. So even if you work for yourself, you can still have a really good time at work. I mean, today I had my little Moroccans and I was just kind of shaking them a little bit. And just, I try to incorporate a little bit of fun. Seriously though, I try to incorporate a little bit of fun in my work every day, even if I have to take a 1 hour break to just step away from everything and go watch something funny or something on YouTube or just whatever. But I incorporate fun in some kind of way. It may not mean a lot to other people that think it's like, you know, minimal, but to me, it makes a difference for my day. I'm gonna talk a little bit about skydiving and what it did for me. And, you know, just the ins and outs of what it costs and where they're located and all that. And what are you talking about?
I'm going to be talking about meal prepping.
Oh, man. You know, I really wish I could do that now, but because my tastes change, I don't know if this food may spoil, but I'm going to have to try that 1 week where I take a couple of things and make something and be able to have something for the whole week. But because I usually spend less than 10 minutes in the kitchen anyway, you know, putting things together, it's really no big deal to cook. But for my birthday in 2020, I went skydiving, and it was something that had been on my bucket list for maybe about 10, 12, 15 years. And I just never did it because I always thought that I wanted to do it with someone, you know, a friend or, you know, your sister or your brother or somebody. I always thought that I had to go and do it with someone. Well, when it got closer time for me taking it serious in September of 2020, nobody wanted to go. Either one, they didn't have the money. Two, they didn't want to make the time. Three, they flaked out because they were scared. Four, I got tired of asking. So I just woke up one day, got dressed, put my tennis shoes and my tights on, and I just went over on my actual birthday and signed up. Took, you have to take a class before you go. I had all the details before I got there. I knew what it was going to cost, how long it was going to take. Mm-hmm. I knew how the process was going to go because I'm, you know, I inquired about that. But I got there and a couple of things I didn't know. I didn't know you had to go through a class before you even did it because they had to give you all the rules of the road, what mm-hmm. to do, what not to do, you know, about the parachute and, you know, safety things, right? Mm-hmm. And then the next thing I didn't know that they weigh you before you pay. They weigh you because if you don't weigh a certain amount of money for one of the instructors who would be maybe to match your weight, you can't go. Mm-hmm. So I didn't know that because I was looking around going, okay, who's the biggest dude out here? Who tall? Who? But it was funny because the guy that went with me, he wasn't tall. We were about the same height, but he was real strong and stocky, like football build. Mm-hmm. But I didn't know that they weighed you. I also didn't know that the day that I went, it was overcast, like cloudy. I stayed there for 4 hours and couldn't go because the sky wasn't 14 feet in the air. The sky wasn't clear enough for us to go. And so even the instructors who go there every day just to get a skydive, because there are people who are really, really into it and maybe they work for themselves or whatever. They go to the skydiving place and they just do a skydive every day to get their day started. Yeah. Like they have the coffee and then they go skydive. Now that right there is a very expensive habit.
I bet.
But if that's what you love, that's what you love. Mm-hmm. The other thing I didn't know is that once you go skydiving, you get a passport thing and you get to mark every time you go, you get hours for it. And then after you get so many skydiving hours in, then you can actually request to go skydiving with a group of people in the air by themselves, or you can go skydiving on your own. Mm. I was like, I don't think my mind will be ready for that ever, just simply because the landing part is very tricky. But it was about $250. From the time I got there to the time I landed was probably about 4 hours because you go through the class, then the instructor takes you through.
I thought you meant 4 hours going through the sky.
No. In the sky, you're literally maybe 30, 45 minutes from the time they load everybody on the plane, take the plane down the runway, get the plane in the air as high as it can go before the clouds. Right. And then by the time they,
I said, that sounds about right.
Yep. And then by the time they, depending on how many people they're pushing out of the plane. And then by the time you get in the air and the GoPro, the other person on the skydive with the GoPro camera is videoing everything for you to get all the significant things. And then they go back down to the bottom because they want to get you landing and you up in the air. Because I have a whole CD with everything on it. I have mm-hmm. every picture, every video. I have all my stuff. So it's about 30, 45 minutes from the beginning action of you getting on that plane to you landing. And we had such a sweet landing. It was so awesome. I mean, our butts touched that ground like it was sitting on a pillow. That's how easy our landing was. And the only thing I was thinking about when we were landing, I saw like large parts of water. And I was like, long as we're not landing in the lake, I'm good. Because all that water was nasty and green and moldy. And I was just like, but some kind of way in the parachute, they can turn the parachute to go to the landing where they want to go. But for me, what it did is it just gave me more confirmation that anything that you're afraid to do that's within your safety realm, just do it. It gave me a boost of confidence of, you know, I really can do anything that I want to do.
That's how I felt about ziplining.
Yeah, being in the air, the air smelled different. It went in and out different. The view was absolutely amazing. I could see all the way to Galveston. I could see all the way over to IKEA. I could see so many things. And I was in Rocheron, Texas. So I would say wherever you live, find a place where you can do some type of adventurous thing, whether it's zip lining, whether it is skydiving, whether it is hiking. It could be any of those things that you think of that you could do. I would love to go hiking. My problem would be the animals. I don't want to be bitten by a coyote. And you know, there's a lot of them in Austin, by the way. I don't want to meet a bear. I'd rather meet Bigfoot or a caveman than to meet any of those other. Me and Bigfoot, we would get along real well.
You ever see that show Finding Bigfoot?
I did. I find that kind of stuff interesting. That and alien stuff, I'm in.
And mermaid stuff.
Yeah. I mean, if it takes my attention, I mean, but I would just say if you're in a town where you could go. Now, my next thing is I really still have on my bucket list to go hot air balloon. riding.
We used to always see one on our street every now and then. Well, your street.
Yeah. They have also the Balloon Fest, where you can sign up for the Balloon Fest and then you get a ride on the actual balloon. Because if you go take a balloon ride by yourself just on a regular day, it's $250 a person. But at the if you go through the Balloon Fest, there are people who have, you know, their own balloons that they'll let you ride on them. I don't know. They're all certified and all that stuff, but I'd rather do it during a Balloon Fest. And my bucket list Balloon Fest is in Albuquerque, New Mexico. So I want to go to that balloon festival. There's a few of them coming up right now, but they're going to all be virtual. I'm not interested in the virtual. I want to be there. I want to be in Albuquerque, New Mexico, in that whole scene of everything. But that's my message today is if there's any kind of adventure, most people don't understand what it does for them until they actually do it.
Mm-hmm.
And once you do it, then you get a whole nother thought process going on in your head.
I believe that, yeah.
Yeah.
My topic is going to be about meal prepping. The mm-hmm. things that I've learned during meal prepping, like I would do at the very beginning when I was serious about it, starting in 2019. Mm-hmm. Well, I did it back in 2017, but getting back into it, mm-hmm. I would cut up some chicken breast in like dices. And then I would season it the way I season chicken, like saute it. But then I also, mm-hmm. once it's fully cooked, I would glaze it like in some honey. Mm-hmm. So I'd cook, it'd be like some sweet seasoned chicken. I would do that with like some broccoli and some, well, really mixed veggies. I would do that. And then it was really good. I just got tired of eating it. And I was like, yeah, I'm gonna have to be one of those people that do two meals and split it up.
Did you buy those containers with the compartments where you could put your vegetable, put your meat, put your
rice? At first I didn't, but because I was doing like the chicken with the rice and mixed veggies, so I could just put it all together and eat it that way. Meals I've learned I had to do the I need to get the ones like Peyton has though.
Hers are the really good ones and they have deep pockets. Hers are like deep. Yeah. So if you put like asparagus cut in half or green beans or some like long vegetable, it would absolutely fit in there. So that is
Yeah, because some for those that get home from work and don't want to do nothing but just shower and just warm sit, all you have to do is just heat it up, yeah, while you're showering or whatever. It comes in handy because some people, they that's their main thing they worry about is having to cook a whole meal or something. But meal planning has been very helpful, especially if you know you got one of those jobs that have you so feeling, you know, beat once you get home. But yeah, that's what I've learned. Maybe two meals split up, maybe do 3 meals of chicken breast with rice and mixed veggies, and then 4 days of the other meal that you want to do, like, and you don't have to do them consecutively. You can do, you know, switch them. So that's worked for me.
I was about to say, it'd be kind of cool if on a Sunday you cooked up 2 separate types of meals, meal prep them and put those in the containers. And then if you ate chicken today, maybe tomorrow you're eating something, another type of meat. And then on that third day, you'd be ready to eat that chicken again or whatever. Or if it was, you know, salad day or something like that. So, you know, that would be an idea too. That way you don't feel like
I showed you for the lettuce wraps, you can do lettuce wraps for a couple of days and then you can do the same thing and either put that in a salad or put it in an actual tortilla. You kind of want to mix it up or change one thing about it or something because you're going to get tired of it and it's not going to make you motivated to do meal prepping.
Exactly.
So,
That's really a good idea because you can get tortillas and you can remix anything into a taco. You can remix anything, you know.
You can even deep fry the corn tortillas and cut them up like in little strips, like the strips you like in your salad. You can put that in a salad or you're making like you can do a lot of stuff. You just have to be creative if you're not one of those that look at YouTube or TikTok recipes and stuff. But these days it's so easy to find, I was gonna say TikTok, but it's easy to find recipes for meal prepping for sure. But that's what I would recommend. Try to do like at least two meals a week. I mean, cause you're gonna end up, if you don't meal prep, you're gonna end up probably eating triple the amount of meals, yeah.
Right. Well, I think those were 2 really good ideas on the, you know, try something extreme like skydiving. And I gave you my experience. It's absolutely wonderful. Mm-hmm. And then the meal prep is so necessary with how busy our lives are with everything, but also just to not have to mess up your kitchen every day cooking. But
that's true.
Yeah. If you want to support our show, our podcast Cash App is $MDI podcast.
Yes, and before we let you go, as always, keep subscribing to our channel. Help us get to 1,000 subscribers. We're almost there. Also, keep liking and commenting on our content because we see the thumbs up and we see the comments coming through our email to respond back to, but also share our channel to those that you feel like might relate to any of the content we've been posting so far.
Absolutely, and that's our show for today, and we'll see you tomorrow. And it's almost over, guys. It's almost over, and I tell you what, I'm excited. We've got a lot of new topics. I've already got them written down. We have so many new topics for February and March, and I'm just excited to be able to share them with you. So as usual, bye for now.
Bye.
Wanting to book us for your show? It could be an expo. It could be any type of women's event. Contact Miller Booking Agency at mail.com. We're looking forward to meeting and greeting with you.